So you want to learn something. You want to learn it well. You want to learn it so well that you get an A on that test, or impress your audience with your command of quotes in that speech, or show off to all your friends that you know how to memorize pi up to 314 digits, and you swear you can get it. It just doesn't help if you keep putting pressure on me when I do it in front of people, so please be quiet, Linda. What you really want to do is work on your memory. But before you can do that, you need to understand your memory, and know how it works in order to take advantage of these strategies. First things first, what is memory? Well, that begs the question, because the current view is that memory can be split up, roughly speaking, into a few kinds. The moment information is received by your body, it enters your sensory memory. Whether it be a sight, a sound, or something you touch, the information is stored in high definition for a brief period of time, before disappearing within, usually, a fraction of a second. This is why, for instance, when you see something move fast, you see where it is, not where it was 1/10 of a second ago. This sensory memory holds a ton of information, all of it that you ever perceive, and you can't memorize it all, it's just too much. And after all, some of it is probably useless. So your mind picks some subsection of it to focus on, whether you consciously draw your attention to it, like when you force yourself to read something that's not all that interesting, or the object is so new, unexpected, or unique that it draws your attention to it, like this oddly dilapidated pink elephant. The information you attend to goes into your working memory, with the rest being simply forgotten. This is basically your short-term memory, where you store information that would be helpful to use or have at hand in the short term, like the last thing someone said in a conversation. You remember it during the conversation, but you probably wouldn't remember it what they said the next week. So what do you remember the next week? Well, on this time frame, the things you remember are considered part of your long-term memory. To get here, information must first be sensed. Then you need to pay attention to it to get it into your working memory without forgetting. And finally, you need to archive or encode it for later use in your long-term memory instead of forgetting it again. This process of encoding is the first place we can look to improve the way we learn. The first thing to know about encoding is that brute forcing it is not the best way. Sure, if you want to, say, keep a phone number in your short-term memory while you look for a pencil, you can say it a bunch of times to help it stay there. But the same principle doesn't keep info in your long-term memory. So simply rereading the book is not your best bet. What you need to do is encode the information more deeply, putting quality over quantity. But what does that actually mean? Deep encoding means encoding based on meaning, not amount of times you study, so that the information is more thoroughly embedded in your memory. It can include actively comparing new material to what you've learned previously, relating the material to yourself, or even making analogies between a concept you're familiar with, keeping in mind, of course, the limitations of your analogy. And speaking of analogies, let's compare your brain to a computer for a moment. Cyborgs aside, the two are largely different, but both do store large quantities of information. And for computers, the key to making this information accessible to you is organization, whether that be your file directory, the list of open programs, or a list of settings available to you. This same principle can be applied to learning. By organizing the information into flowcharts, diagrams, or concept maps, you can relate multiple concepts in a more explicit manner to one another, and make it easier to encode. But in continuing with the computer analogy, uploading mass quantities of data to your hard drive is useless if you can't access it from there. This is where the concept of retrieval, or getting information out of your long-term memory and back into your working memory, comes into play. And from here, we get our second area of improving memory, relating encoding and retrieval. One consistent finding of memory research is that you remember things better when you encode it in the same manner you will retrieve it. For instance, studying the definition of words does help you understand it more deeply, but you'd be out of luck if the test was on finding the words based on what they rhyme with. This seems intuitive enough, but often it gets lost. Always keep in mind why you're studying the material. Is this equation something I need to memorize and reproduce, apply to a problem, know how to derive from scratch? Keep your goals in mind and study the material by practicing it in the way in which you will retrieve it. And lastly, let's focus on retrieval by itself, the act of drawing information back out from your long-term memory. How do you improve this? Well, the key is to utilize cued recall. This happens all the time without you even thinking about it. Like when a song from a while ago makes you remember something you were thinking about back then. Essentially, your perception of one thing serves as a cue, triggering the recollection of a closely related memory. So let's say you study the formula for GDP, and it's on the tip of your tongue. You might try starting by going through what you can remember, like what GDP stands for, the kinds of GDP that exist, and the purpose of using the GDP. And maybe that doesn't help you, but it does make you remember some parts of the GDP, and before you know it, you finally remember the equation. So there you have it, a few evidence-based techniques to improve the way you learn. They may be hard or perhaps unintuitive to apply, but remember the underlying process, apply them, and the results will follow. And as a challenge, try using one of the tips I provided to help you actually learn the tips themselves. Comment below to let me know what you did and how that works for you.